Playboys, Miss November, Pia Reyes, Miss January, Luann Lee, Miss July, Hope Carlton, Miss June, Rebecca Ferrati, and Miss March, Donna Spear. Centerfolds of the 1980s, ready for action. Playing against 1990s centerfolds, Miss January, Peggy McIntaggart, Playmate of the Year, Renee Tennyson, Miss April, Lisa Matthews, Miss February, Pamela Anderson, and Miss July, Jacqueline Sheen. On your marks for Family Feud, monumental, earth-shaking Battle of the Centerfolds. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, centerfolds of the 90s. Hello, centerfolds of the 80s. Will you welcome Donna Spear?
Oh, hello.
Hi, Donna.
Hi.
Now, everyone on this team were centerfolds during the 1980s. And I'd like you to introduce who you brought and the charity that you'll be playing for.
Well, first of all, on my right is Hope Marie Carlton. Luann Lee is next to her. Pia Reyes and Rebecca Ferrati. And we...
Yeah. Well, all right. And you're going to be playing for a very wonderful charity.
We're playing for Children of the Night.
Which is?
It's an organization for protecting abused children.
What a Yay! Wonderful charity. Five very lovely women. But can you beat the beauties of the 90s? Right now, ladies and gentlemen, thunderous applause for the beauties of the 90s. Lisa Matthews. Now,
yes.
You were Miss April.
Yes.
1990.
Right.
Now, who did you bring with you?
I have Peggy McIntaggart.
Hello. She was Miss January.
Miss January.
Somebody told me these things. I don't know.
Do you have them memorized?
Go ahead.
Okay, good. We have Renee Tennyson, who was the Playmate of the Year.
Yes, how about that? And?
Pamela Anderson and Jacqueline Sheen.
What is your charity?
We are playing for the Freedom to Read Foundation.
Which is? Which is?
It supports libraries and other similar institutions.
Look at five beautiful women who are into learning. Uh-huh. But let's hope that we have fun when we play The Feud. Let's go, Donna, right now. The first team to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play Fast Money for the $10,000. Good luck to both. We ask 100 people this question, and we put the top five answers on that board. Try to find the most popular answer to this question. Name something that girls living at home get in trouble for, that boys living at home usually get away with. We go right here to Lisa.
Staying out after curfew.
She says staying out after curfew.
Yes.
Number one, you think of a steal, Donna. Hi, Peggy.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good. Has anyone ever told you that you look like Angie Dickinson?
Yes, they have.
They have?
Yes, they have.
So I guess that's a bad line for me to use. Okay, nothing original. Can you answer something that girls living at home get in trouble for that the boys don't?
Yes, drinking.
Good answer. Good answer.
Yes.
Are you with her crowd or not?
Yes.
Let me see. Drinking. There it is. Hi, Renee.
Hi.
What would you get in trouble for that a boy living at home usually didn't?
Using the telephone.
All right, let me see. The telephone. You like that, huh, Donna? Oh, Pamela, you have a look of like you're going to get them back in your eye. What do you say? Did you have brothers?
One brother.
And
he had to do everything, and I couldn't do anything.
Well, name something that he got away with that you didn't.
Driving the car.
Show me car. Two strikes. $50 in the bank. Those beauties of the 80s will get a chance to still look at this smile.
Hi.
Is that smile registered? Well, that is illegal. What do you say?
Smoking.
Okay.
That's a good answer.
You're still alive on the question. If we see smoking. Yes, sir.
All right.
What do you say?
I say probably not doing as well in school.
If you're living at home, girls get in trouble for it. The boys usually get away with not doing well in school. Three strikes. Who is going to take the bank first? Here we go. Something that girls living at home usually get in trouble for, that boys living at home usually get away with.
Dating someone older.
Dating? Did you ever? Never mind.
Watching TV.
Watching TV.
Hanging with the rough kind of crowd.
Yeah.
Going out on a date.
Okay, there's a lot of different answers.
What is it?
Going on a date.
All right.
Close.
3 seconds.
Dating.
If it's up there, you've stolen the bank. You've got first blood. Let me see if you get in trouble for dating. No. The women of the 90s. Now, we heard some different answers there. Let's see the two that would have stolen you the bank. Let's see if the crowd knew this. What do girls get in trouble for that boys get away with? Number two.
Sex.
I don't judge it. The judge, they're saying that dating is sex. That's what they're saying. That's what they're saying.
Okay, so we're from the 80s.
Yeah, the judge wants to know if you're available for a date. All right. Number four, pregnant. Yes, no boy gets in trouble for being pregnant. We're coming right back with a lot more feuding fun. You don't want to miss it. Good luck. Good luck. Sit down, sir. Here we go. The top seven answers are on the board. Name something that is supposed to happen when there is a full moon. Peggy?
Romance.
Oh, she says, romance. It's there, but three answers will give you control, Hope. Something that's supposed to happen when there's a full moon.
You have good luck.
Okay. For me, that's the same as romance. Let me see good luck. Oh, right there. Here we go. We're going with the women of the 90s.
All right.
Renee, one more time. Now, full moons. What's supposed to happen?
Werewolves come out.
All right.
Let me see. A werewolf. The number one answer. Maybe they're coming out for a little romance. That was a very good joke. Pamela?
Dogs howl.
Dogs howl.
Very good answer. Do dogs howl?
Yes.
Yes, they do, and there's $46 in the bank. Jacqueline, full moons, what is supposed to happen in our survey?
Crazy things.
Crazy things?
Not...
Let me see. Crazy things. There it is, number two. Lisa, what do you say? You're not friends here because you're going for $10,000.
We hate them today.
No. Okay, what do you say?
High tide.
High tide. Let me see a high tide. It's there. The women of the 80s in trouble. Peggy, what do you say?
People become more psychic.
People become more psychic. Strike one. Renee.
Oh my God, I can't think of one.
Just close your mind, go blank. I'll read the question, give me the first thing, and you have 3 seconds. Something that happens. It is supposed to happen when there is a full moon.
Halloween, maybe?
Okay. Yeah. Let me see. Halloween. It was an effort. Now, don't be nervous, but if you fail to give me one of those two answers, $69 up for grabs. Pamela. 3 seconds. Take a guess. She was saying it. What did you say? You were saying?
Feel sexy. Sex happens.
She said, feel sexy. Sex
good
happens.
Answer.
Yes. All right. Yes. Good. Yes.
You're still alive if we see sex. Not that. All right. Can you do it? Name something that is supposed to happen when there is a full moon. What do you say, Rebecca?
Mood change.
Mood change, Pia.
Your hair grows longer.
Your hair grows longer.
More crime.
More crime?
You stay out late.
You stay out late, Donna.
People get murdered.
People. Are you? What is your answer?
Mood change.
All right. 3 seconds, and you say?
Personality change.
Yeah.
Clear enough? If it's there, you have stolen $69 if a full moon causes a personality change. The women of the 90s keep their bank. You failed to steal it again. Our survey says when there's a full moon, number 3 happens. Birth. What are those werewolves doing? And number 6. More. Who said that? Luann said it. We're coming back. There's a long way to go before somebody plays for $10,000. Won't you hurry back? The top 5 answers on the board. We ask 100 people. When you were a kid, what was your favorite toy? Luann?
Barbie doll!
Let me see. Barbie doll. It's number 1. You think of a steal. The dollar value's doubled. What do you say, Pia? It's your first chance to take control. When you were a kid, what was your favorite toy?
Log cabins.
Well, let me see. A log cabin.
There's log.
Hope for the women of the 90s. Rebecca, what do you say?
Jack in the box.
Rebecca liked Jack in the box. 2 strikes. $122 will take them closer. What do you say, Donna?
Roller skate.
You're still alive.
Yeah!
If a favorite toy was a roller skate. Yes! $130 in that bank. Oh.
Come on, Hope.
Okay, my building set.
All right, let me see. To stay alive, a building set.
Come on.
No. Let's see if they can steal this big bank. $130. When you were a kid, what was your favorite toy, Jacqueline?
G.I. Joe.
G.I. Joe. That's funny because Barbie was mine. Pamela? Trains? Trains? Trucks, trains? What do you want her to say?
Fire.
Tell her?
Fire truck. Trains.
What do you think?
Trains.
All right, you've got 3 seconds to...
Okay.
What is it?
Little cars and trains.
Little, like, model cars.
Yes!
If it's there, you've stolen $130. Show me little model cars. No! The women of the 80s are in this game with the lead. Favorite toys, no one knew. Number 2. Bicycle. Number 4. Ball. Number 5. Wagon. $3 separate the teams as we go with another face-off. Here we go. Pam. Pia against Pamela. Triple the dollar value. We put the top 4 answers on the board. Listen carefully. We're going to go a little quicker. Whoever takes this question could win the game. Name something that every woman hates to discover. Pamela.
Pimples.
She okay. The scary discovery of pimples. Not there. Pia?
A mistress.
All right, how about a mistress? It's bottom of the survey. Think of a steal. We triple the dollar value. Something that every woman hates to discover.
Wrinkles.
Show me wrinkles. Bam, it's number 2.
Okay.
All right, Donna.
Stretch marks.
Yeah, come on.
Could it be stretch marks?
Baby.
Not there. What do you say, Hope?
That they're pregnant.
Good answer, Hope.
Let me see. Being pregnant. 2 strikes and $75 will give them a bigger lead. Luann, you keep your team alive.
How
something
about,
every woman hates to discover.
How about she's tipping the scale?
Yay!
Let me see. Putting on the pounds. There it is. The bank goes up. Pia, if you give me number 1, that bank's going way up. What is it? The most popular answer. What does every woman, something that every woman hates to discover?
Her age.
Okay. You're still alive if we see. You finally discover how old you really are. Not there. You will take this. If you take $117, what do you say? something every woman hates to discover.
Gray hair.
Gray hair? Pamela?
Gray hair.
Gray hair?
Gray hair.
Gray hair? All right, Lisa, what do you say?
Gray hair.
You say?
Gray hair.
$117 coming here if we see gray hair. You've got that bank. $244 against $130, and here we go. It's another face-off right now. Rebecca against Jacqueline. We triple the dollar value. The top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Whoever takes it should win the game. Name something a bride does immediately after she says her I do's. Jacqueline.
Buys a dress.
She buys a dress. Not fair. Rebecca, name something a bride does immediately after she says her I do's.
She kisses the groom.
Let me see, kiss the groom. Number one, you think of a steal. You can win the game, Don. What do you say?
I say she goes back down the aisle.
Does she go back down the aisle?
Come on.
No.
Oh.
Either team can win, Hope.
Come on, Hope.
She goes to her reception.
Let's see, reception. Women of the 90s can win, Luann, if you don't know.
Okay.
Right after, immediately, she says her I do's.
How much she lifts that veil?
Let me see this. But stay alive. Lift the veil. Here you go. If you fail to give it to me, they will win the game. Something brides do immediately after they say their I do's.
Pick out the ring.
Pick out the ring. Pamela.
Cry.
Cry. Renee.
Dance with her dad.
Dance.
Faint.
What?
Faint.
Faint. All right. One answer will win you this game. What might it be? Quickly.
Cries.
She said cries. If it's up there, the women of the 80s may be crying because you have $10,000. Show me crying. To the beautiful women of the 80s, there are two answers that would have kept you alive. Immediately after women say their I do's, number three. Smile. And number four. Throw the bouquet. You stay right there, and I need two players for $10,000. Who's it gonna be right now? Very quickly. Who's playing? You're first? With me, Renee. We've got the most beautiful Playboy centerfold. Renee, centerfold of the year, playing for $10,000 right after this. We put 15 seconds on the clock. We wish good luck to Renee. We ask 100 people these questions. Name an occupation you would like to see more women in.
Surgeon.
A brand of wristwatches.
Quartz.
How many nights a week single people go on dates?
Two.
An occasion when people give you gifts of money.
Birthday.
Something people get kicked out of.
Bar.
Turn around, let's see how you did with those guys. An occupation you would like to see more women in, you said? A surgeon. Survey said 32. Very nice. A brand of wristwatch you selected. Quartz. Survey said 0. I think that's a type. How many nights a week single people go on dates? You said 2 nights a week. And our survey said 15. An occasion when people give you gifts of money, you said birthday. Our survey said 47. Something that people get kicked out of, you had no doubt when you said the bar. Our survey said bam, 48. Back with your teammates as Peggy comes to the stage. 23 points. Good luck. Peggy, you stand on that line. You look straight ahead. You need 23 points for that $10,000. We put 20 seconds on the clock. If you hear this sound, it means hug me if you get the money. Here we go. We ask 100 people, name an occupation you would like to see more women in.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what
occupation you'd like to see more women in.
Flying.
A brand of wristwatches.
Timex.
How many nights a week single people go on dates?
6.
An occasion when people give you gifts of money.
Birthdays.
So, try again. Quickly. All right, turn around. You've got 3 of the 5. You need 23 points. I hope that you did well with those. Here we go. Name an occupation you would like to see more women in. You said flying. Our survey said 5. Physician was number 1, 18 points away. A brand of wristwatches. You said? Timex. Did 18 people say it? For $10,000 for the foundation to read, what did our survey say? Give them the cash. Come out here and let her know. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
A member of our studio audience will receive... This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. Meet Playboys, Miss November, Pia Reyes. Miss January, Luann Lee. Miss July, Hope Carlton. Miss June, Rebecca Ferrati. And Miss March, Donna Spear. Centerfolds of the 1980s, ready for action. Playing against 1990s centerfolds, Miss January, Peggy McIntaggart. Playmate of the Year, Renee Tennyson. Miss April, Lisa Matthews. Miss February, Pamela Anderson. And Miss July, Jacqueline Sheen. On your marks for Family Feud. Monumental, earth-shaking, Battle of the Centerfolds. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, Centerfolds of the 90s. Hello, Centerfolds of the 80s. Will you welcome Donna Spear?
Oh, hello.
Hi, Donna.
Hi.
Now, everyone on this team were centerfolds during the 1980s, and I'd like you to introduce who you brought and the charity that you'll be playing for.
Well, first of all, on my right is Hope Marie Carlton. Luann Lee is next to her. Pia Reyes and Rebecca Ferrati. And we...
Yeah. Well, all right. And you're going to be playing for a very wonderful charity.
We're playing for Children of the Night.
Which is?
It's an organization for protecting abused children.
What a Yay! Wonderful charity. Five very lovely women. But can you beat the beauties of the 90s? Right now.